a grateful heart, give thanks to the Holy One. Give thanks because He's given Jesus Christ, His Son. Give thanks with a grateful heart. Give thanks to the Holy One. Give thanks because He's given Jesus Christ.
Testimony is a testimony for this ministry.
Amen.
Is to say what God is doing in this ministry is not a joke.
Amen.
The Lord has started doing something great in this ministry.
Amen.
And as you partake into this grace, the Lord is going to do something in your life.
Glory.
This my testimony came about because some people came to me over some time ago, and they were telling me about how this ministry, maybe because they have money, they went to take some people from another church and they begin to do it. So I was troubled in my heart. I was troubled, though in that, when they said that, I said, if that is the case, it's not good though. Then because of the trouble that I have in my heart, I could not sleep. I was trying to, you know, ask questions. Why would this be? And is this supposed to be? So it happened that over time, in my sleep, I had a voice. And the voice said, divine mandate. So, I never knew that this poster was written here, the mandate. Until when I was discussing it with a brother here, and he now pointed at that poster, divine mandate. But I was inside my room when I heard the word divine mandate. So I'm giving this testimony because after the children must have been brought out, it is for the name of the Lord to be glorified. Praise God.
We have interesting message. At least, imagine I call it interesting message for once, because it's a message that God used to minister to me this morning, and I know that we minister to you too in Jesus' name. When there were 7 weeks of divine intervention, this year God gave us precisely, I heard His voice, said plant churches, build, establish, and increase. And we declare this year of increase. Devil say it's decrease. You see, God say increase, devil says decrease, but who will win? God is a winner. So that is why we are in our 7 weeks of divine intervention. During our 22 days fasting and prayer, I was here and I said, I heard a voice said to me, divine intervention, we need God. God already speak because God knows there are battles. I heard a voice said to me, divine intervention, and God said to me, declare 7 weeks, every Sunday, divine intervention. That is that thing we cannot do because of weakness, that God should help us. So that is why we're in 7 weeks of divine intervention. That means divine help. God, I can't do it again. God, I'm tired. God, I don't know how to do it. God, I don't know whether I have the problem. God, I don't understand anymore. God, help me. That is the weeks we are in. Last week we said the mistake and the error of an enemy to give us a promotion. And we saw the story of Esther, how the mistake of Queen Vashti make Esther to become a queen, a slave girl. And today now, second week of divine intervention, we still have 5 weeks. The topic say, he that must win. He that must win. I think if some people that are current with boxing, talk about Mike Tyson. They said a time came when people are still paying tickets to enter to go and watch Mike Tyson, the game will be over. I think it's Mike Tyson. People are still queuing to pay. Before they finish paying tickets, Mike Tyson don't knock the person down one hand. So it was just, if he could delay for people to pay, but this thing is already in him. So people already know that Mike Tyson will win. He that must win. You know, there are people you set in battle. Imagine you bring me now, and you bring a little baby, say, come and fight with me. Do you need any results? You're already getting the result before the battle. Imagine you bring me, you now bring my little boy, or my little girl, you say, come and fight with me. And you give us a fight. What happened? You have already determined. People will not even watch. Will anybody pay money to watch that? Because this one will before the result. Somebody said, tomorrow is Monday, and if I come up here now and prophesy, God bless you, brother. The Lord said I should tell you that tomorrow is Monday. What will congregation say? And then they are still listening. He said, Pastor, carry on. He said, I should let you know that tomorrow is Monday. Yes, Pastor. Tomorrow is Monday. Yes, Pastor. And God said, know that tomorrow is Monday. Is it a news? Is that a prophecy? Because tomorrow is Monday. What the brother wants to hear is, what will happen on Monday? They're going to bring money. That's what he wants to hear. Don't tell me what I know. It's just like you call my name, Gloria. Yes. What do we listen to? The next, what is going to happen? So he that must win. Sometimes when you are watching football match, they are beating somebody 7-0. I will tell my husband, the person is still playing. He said, but they must finish it. They are beating you 10-0. You that they are beating 10-0, they are still changing. You see somebody jogging around the field. He's about to come and do what? 92 minutes, beating you 10-0. The coach is still changing person. I said, what is he expecting to do? To win? They will say, no, make it just get one goal. Are you see me? So he that must win, must win. But it doesn't mean we don't fight. That Matasi must win does not automatically give him the medal or the gold or whatever. He must still go and fight. That you will fulfill your destiny does not mean we wake up and enter a car and be driving. You will still go and fight. So he that must win, as already determined by God, has been determined. The difference in whether you will win is the process. How you approach it. He that must win. Now God said, this year, go increase. Devil said, Allah, you will decrease. It's not negotiable, because he that said, go increase, is bigger. It's not the creator that says, go and decrease. Are you seeing the difference? So I always tell people, what did God tell you about your life? Because if God said something about you and you decide to follow God, let heaven and earth crash. That thing God says must come to pass. If God gives you an assurance that you are my own, that I will bless you, that will make it to be a blessing, you can be suffering now without food. It does not mean that is who you are. You can be confused now. You might not be having heart rates. But what God said was said before all those circumstances. What God said was your inbuilt. Before God thought of you, he built you with what he wants you to be. That's why I said the earth waited for the manifestation. Did you hear the song? Divinely connected to God. Because the earth is waiting. Now, the day God pick you out to create you, He has already figured out to create you for something. He didn't waste his time bringing you to life. He did it. And everybody is divinely created with 1, 2, 3 mandates. 1 talent, 2 talents, and 5 talents. Everybody, according to their several abilities. And once some 1 talent are flying greater heights, from 5 talents have not discovered their own. If you like carry 5 until you discover it, if somebody that have 1 discover it, they begin to say hi. He that must win, we win. But there are always battles to fight. When they fought Christ, Bible says everywhere Christ was going, they were fighting. When they killed him finally, Bible says, if they have known that killing him will bring you and I to church today, they wouldn't have killed him. So killing him was not his failure. He came to die. Killing him helped him fulfill his destiny. But you and I did not come to die, because he has paid the price. Peter said, don't go. He said, I must go. If I don't go, where comes the comforter? If I don't go, where begins your ministry? I must go for you to begin. Children of Israel were in captivity for years. 430 years. The enemy said, hey, I don't finally capture them. Can you imagine people that were captured for 430 years? You think the devil thought they would be free one day again? That is why most of us, you are in some situations, you believe that so your level of courage. Now lie. 430 years, people were dying, people were being born. As far as a fellow was concerned, these are now my perpetual slaves. I don't buy them, I don't get them. But he forgot that they were divinely called. When a man is called by God, the enemy must fight. Most times, the enemy will always seem to be gaining ground. When you watch those films, those days when we were growing up, do you know that normally, when it is the last fight, the boss always gets ground more than the actor? The boss will beat the actor and beat the actor to stupor. It is when the actor is about to die. You say, we will begin to ask, who is the boss and who is the actor? When the actor is like begins to die, begins to rise, before you know it, one touch, bam, you now know who is the actor and the boss. Sometimes, when the battle becomes tense, you begin to ask yourself, did I really know God? Am I even serving God? That is why Bible say, if you faint in the days of adversity, your strength is small. Proverbs 24:10. Why? Because adversity must come. Adversity is trouble. Jesus speaking in Mark 10, 29 to 30. Peter said, Master, we have left to follow you. Where's our reward? He said, you get everything in 100-fold, including tribulation. Everything. So when tribulation comes, don't focus on tribulation. Focus on the calling and the gifting. Because tribulation must come. The demons came to kill, to steal, and to destroy their ministry. And they will minister it until the end come. So if they don't trouble you, where would they operate? They trouble me and I trouble them. That is how the earth is being lived. The devil have his mission. Death, destruction, failure. And Jesus said, I have come that you may have life and live it more abundantly. So immediately they trouble me, I am done. I rise up again. He said, Micah said, don't laugh over me, my enemy, for when I fall 7 times, I will rise again. Bible says, just man falleth 7 times and rise again. Did he say we don't fall? 7 times. He fell today. Demon go sit down, put. He dey lace his head. I catch you. You have been praying like a baba. Go lace him here. Lace him here. Demon lace, lace. After he go rise, Holy Spirit go help him. He overcome. He said, wow, I've overcome. Begin bounce. Demon give him space. After some years, by the time he forgets himself, Bible says, he that taketh his tongue, take heed lest he fall. By the time believer have arrived, demons say, he don't relax. Come again, bust him again, back, he fall. That's what battle be. By the time he rise again, say, what? Back, finish demon. Begin to relax. Bible says, through trials and temptation, we enter the kingdom of God. Unless you are no more on this earth. If you are on this earth, demons come. That's why you only need grace and fire to contend. He said, fight the good fight. Because surely they will gather. When God says surely, is he joking? Surely they will. Not they may. Maybe sometimes. For sure they will gather. But because God is not in their gathering, he's in your gathering. He will scatter their gathering. That's what he said. In scripture. They started fighting from beginning. They fought Abraham without child. That is the greatest battle. 99 years, people mocking him. Did they not fight Moses? Did they not fight Jacob? Fight. Jacob said, no matter who fight me, labor wasted Jacob about 17 to 20 years. But 20 years in life. And when he woke up and said, I have to change, let's fight. He fought and said, God, change my story. Until God pulled off after the battle, he had an injury and he became great. Did Isaac not fight? Pharaoh pursued him. Joseph, that one, and Joseph is within this range. We thought about it. But today, we want to look from a case of a gate man in the Bible. A gate man in the Bible. Few minutes, I pray that God will help us to verify. Esther 2:19. And when the virgins were gathered together the second time, then Mordecai sat in the king's gate. Esther has not yet shown Mordecai, shown her kindred, nor her people, as Mordecai has charged her. For Esther did the commandment of Mordecai, like as when she was brought up with him. In those days, while Mordecai sat in the king's gate, two of the king's chamberlains, Bigthan and Teresh, of those which kept the door, were wroth, and sought to lay hand on the king Ahasuerus. And the king was not to Mordecai, who told it unto Esther, the queen. And Esther certified the king thereof in Mordecai's name. And when inquisition was made of the matter, it was found out, therefore, they were both hanged on a tree, and it was written in the book of the Chronicles before the king. Now let me explain for them. When Mordecai was now at the gate, a gate man in the house of the king, there were two servants of the king that were angry with the king. They wanted to kill him. And Mordecai saw the plan to kill the king, and he revealed it. As he revealed it, the two men were hanged. These are men that planned coup, treachery. The two men were hanged, and they were killed. To tell you how tough the issue was, because they were to betray the king and kill him. But the gate man Mordecai had it and told the matter, and the king took the two men and killed them. And the thing was written in the book of the kings, book of stories. Anybody that do anything good, they will write it down. Put a date and kept it. That is the place we just read. Now let's go further. After Esther chapter 3 from verse 1. And these things did King Ahasuerus promote Haman, the son of Hammedata, the Agagite, and advanced him, and set his seat above all the princes that were with him. And all the king's servants that were in the king's gate bowed and reverenced Haman. For the king had so commanded concerning him. But Mordecai bowed not, nor did him reverence. Verse 8, jump to 8. And Haman said unto King Ahasuerus, there is a certain people scattered abroad and dispersed among the people in all the provinces of thy kingdom, that their laws are diverse from all people, neither keep they the king's law. Therefore, it is not for the king's profit to suffer them. If it please the king, let it be written that they may be destroyed. And I will pay 10,000 talents of silver to the house of those that have the charge of the business to bring it to the king's treasure. And the king took his ring from his hand and gave it unto him by the son of Hammedata, the Agagite, the Jews' enemy. And the king said unto Haman, the silver is given to thee, the people also, to do with them as it seemed good to thee. Now let me take a short story here also, because I want you to follow up. When Mordecai was not there after revealing this matter, the king did not even remember him. There was a man that was very close to the king called Haman. Haman took the glory that he was the one that revealed the secret, and the Haman was promoted in place of Mordecai. How painful it was, but he was a gate man. He was a Jew, he was a captive. But the man of the city took his position. Now, as he took his position, each time he is coming, every other gate man will bow to salute him. But Mordecai said, I am a Jew. A Jew means a son of God, Israel, the chosen ones. I can't bow to man. And I tell you, even if he was to bow for the work's sake, he couldn't have bowed to that man who took his position. Haman said, I can't bow to Haman. So his friend said, if Haman know that you are not bowed, he will destroy you. They told Haman to know what he will do. And as Haman was coming, the friend said, Mordecai doesn't bow to you. Imagine a slave, a gate man, in a palace where you have say, you are next to the king. Ordinary gate man does not bow to you. Ordinary gate man, Mordecai. That is what I always tell us. It's not what people call you ordinary, it's what you call yourself. Mordecai was an ordinary gate man by title, but by the inside and grace, he knew he was a Jew. By title, he was made a gate man, but by grace, he was never a gate man. He knew who he was, that it was condition that make him a gate man at that time. He could see future. So he refused to bow. Now when Haman saw that he didn't bow, Haman went to the king and said, King, you have some people here that are threats to this kingdom. King, I want to let you know that if these people continue in this kingdom, they will scatter your home. They will scatter this land. Destroy them. And I myself will add money, 10,000 silver. I don't know who has placed money to destroy you. I see it back to sender. To see the wickedness of the devil. King, no excuse. King, don't say there is no money. King, I have already volunteered. Instead of money to make people wear, maybe the wife was looking for one silver at home. Or a friend was looking for 10 silver. He did it. That day he knew he had 10,000 silver. The last couple in his account, who knows? Because immediately he sees Mordecai, he wants to get man, a gate man, coming to oppress me in my kingdom. Just like some Spanish people in this land. Sometimes when they see black man doing well, he look as if careless. A lady said to me one day that a man was running after the children, better to Paris. I tell her, what do you remember this Paris? When are they better, you go your Paris. Better to Paris. He ran. A woman was not running with the children because a man just saw her color. A frustrated man. I was telling her, better to Paris. That is the cause of the problem. This was what these people faced. Mordecai must die. He said, Mordecai alone will not even die. That the old Jews, he don't know that when you plan that a child of God will die, that day you already sign your generation to die. If you see some battles God fight for us, you won't understand. You didn't even manage the Mordecai. Maybe Mordecai have left God, you don't know. You said the whole Jews. You don't even know that it was God that even wanted to punish them that make you able to capture them in the first instance. If God was not working against them, you couldn't have caught up them because they were God's special people. He said, I will pay to make sure they are destroyed. As he stretched hands, the king stretched his hands and he gave him a ring. When the king gives you a ring, ring means authority. That is a seal. He said, take this ring, write anything you like and seal it by my ring. Imagine you give Amrabah your checkbook to sign. You're not going to sign all your money. You sign all. Now you now give a devil that wants to keep people a ring of authority You didn't write the letter, self. Maybe you will manage some. I don't, maybe the king has forgotten that the wife was also a Jew. The king has forgotten that the wife has family outside. Because the man said, I will pay. The demon thought they have overcome. That is why I told us at the beginning. Sometimes when you see they are raging, they thought they have won the home. They thought they have won the family. They don't know that there is still a remnant somewhere. And it is them that will still make the mistake that will bring in the remnant. It is them. He gave him a king, a ring, and he went and write so-so and so-so day, all the Jews. It was like saying, so-so and so-so day, Father, Son, and the Holy Ghost in heaven be destroyed. Because he said, touch not my anointed and do my prophet no harm. He said, I have the power to kill and to make alive. He said, he suffered no man to do the wrong. They go from country to country and no man could do them any wrong. And one man wake up one day, say, go and clear all the Jews. Long story made short, they wrote letter, seal it. Okada begin to go from one city to another. One postman begin to, he dispatch it so rapidly and give the social date. Anybody that see Jew, that is the day that has been declared that every Jew must die. And now put yourself in the position of those people. Sometimes when little thing happens to us, it looks as if the world wants to end. Put yourself, captivity pursued them to another land, made them slave. When they were like relaxed, the Bible said Esther was not yet announced to the kindred. They have not even known that somebody of their own have even become a palace queen. There's no way the sometimes it is when it is about for you to celebrate that the devil arose. These people were to celebrate. Bible said, Mordecai have taught Esther, don't say yet. Don't forget that in verse 17, Esther was welcome. Verse 18, Esther was given a place. In verse 19, battle started. Esther have not even shown it to the kindred. Mordecai was about to celebrate. Ah, my great work is about to be over because my daughter is not the queen. The devil knew that Mordecai was about to celebrate. And they said, let's cut him off fast. Master, when the storm is raging, it's because you are about to cross over. That was when Mordecai wrote a letter to Esther. He said, Esther, better rise up and fight. Esther said, I can't. If I go to the king without appointment, he will kill me. He said, but you don't know why you are there for such a time as this. Kalabosha. Kalabosha. Why will God put you there? This thing has been happened. I never bow to Emma. I have never bowed to Emma for years. I've been a gate man. God knew that Emma was going to rise up that morning and say, why didn't you bow? But a day or a little while before that time, God went and put Esther. God is the best planner on earth. He knows. Mordecai is not proud not to bow. Mordecai is serving me. He knows Mordecai is a good man. Even when he revealed evil, Mordecai would have joined the evil. He revealed it. He knows. He knows that. So, last week I talked about having a memuna in the hem of affair. Somebody that will interfere. God knows that Hema is so strong. Ali Bosha. God knows that Emma was not an ordinary man. He was next to the king. God knows that the king will easily remove his ring and give to Emma. God knows what. We don't know tomorrow. God knows where you have not entered. He knows that king trusted Emma. He knows that king will just give Emma a ring. Say, take. For you to tell somebody, write anything you like in my letter. In any letter, pass it in my name. Don't you trust the person? A letter. You know what is letter? When a letter is delivered, somebody can be killed. For you to say, dear, write my letter. Don't you know that a man have to trust the wife? If you even have a problem with your wife, she are not going to say letter. She are ah! For somebody to say, write letter, write anything you want. Take my ring, Nami writer. Nami, when you see the king ring, na king writer. God knew that her man was so wicked and was ready to wipe out the Jews. That was why God made Vashti to make mistake from the beginning. He said, there is a hammer want to destroy Mordecai. Who will be in that palace that will be so close to the king, Mother Haman? Ali Ebosha. I want to believe here that even Haman was closer to the king, Mother Queen Vashta. That was why it was not difficult for Vashta to say no to the king. I want to say that Haman was so influential on the king. There are friends that are more influential to men more than their wife. I want to see Haman now that he was so close to the king. And God knows that there must be somebody more closest that can be able to annul Haman. God knows what Haman wants to do. The devil have arranged that date. That's also date Haman was going to meet Mordecai. That's also date Haman. You are alive because God make you to cross that line. When they were planning, God was arranging something else. God knows. So when the time came, if not long story cut short, when Mordecai say, Esther, you want to see us to die? Esther said, I'm not, there's nothing we do. Mordecai said, well, Esther, if you don't do something now, God must bring somebody from somewhere to help the Jews. That is why we should have confidence in him. In Esther 4, 15 and 16. He said, help, we arose from somewhere. He said, but you don't know why you are there for such a time as this. If you all together hold your peace, help will come from somewhere, and you and your families can be destroyed. It doesn't matter what the enemy is planning. God has his master plan. He that must win, must win. One with God is majority. Who is he that says, and it cometh to pass, if God is not there? Haman was happy. Rabosha, I've got them. Let's move ahead. Esther chapter 4, next page. 1 to 4. Esther 4. When Mordecai perceived all that was done, Mordecai arranged his clothes and put on sackcloth. After they have shared letter, let's destroy them. He put on sackcloth and went out to the midst of the city and cried with a loud voice and was bitter. And came even before the king's gate. For none might enter into the king's gate clothed with sackcloth. And in every province, whithersoever the king's commandment and his decree came, there was great mourning among the Jews. They were fasting, weeping, and wailing. And many lay in sackcloth. So Esther made her chamberlains came and told her, then was the queen exceedingly grieved. And she sent raiment to cover Mordecai and to take away his sackcloth. Let's take 13. Then Mordecai commanded to Esther, 13 down, quickly, because of time, just take some verses. Think not with thyself that thou shalt escape in the king's house more than all the Jews. For if thou altogether hold thy peace at this time, there shall dear enlargement and deliverance arise to the Jews from another place. But thou and thy father's house shall be destroyed. And who knoweth whether thou art come to this kingdom for such a time as this? Thou art your peace, Esther. Who know? Do you know, for such a time as this, which means this critical time, who know where God took you there? Who know where Vashta misbehaved? Who know that Haman had this plan? No, Haman didn't wake up one day, Haman planned it. Esther, he said, if you keep quiet, that is why they that believe in their God, they shall be strong and do exploits. He didn't say, Esther, if you don't go, we will die. He said, no, he knows his God. He was so confident that God must do something somehow. He said, Esther, if you keep quiet, enlargement, did you see that? His trouble was not seen as trouble. He saw it as enlargement. I said, what you see is what you get. Who knows whether enlargement and deliverance will come from another place? When Esther heard that, he said, I'm determined that if I perish, I perish. Do you see that there are times cases are so critical? Have you been in such a situation? Most of us have never been there. I've never been there. Most of us have never been in that situation. That case is now so tough that if you enter the king's palace without being invited, you can be dead. You can be killed. And your people told you they want to kill all of them. So you better go and sacrifice your life or they kill them. So you now choose to go and try life or death. And God was so kind. She went in and she succeeded. Quickly for time's sake. Next page, Esther 5, verse 3 to 5. Pick some lessons, I'll go on now. Then said the king unto her, verse 3, what with thou, Queen Esther? And what is thy request when he entered the king's palace? He shall be given thee to half of thy kingdom. And Esther answered, if he seem good unto the king, let the king and Haman come this day unto the banquet that I have prepared for him. Then the king said, cause Haman to make us, that he may do as Esther has said. So the king and Haman came to the banquet that Esther have prepared. When king and Haman now met, when Esther was able to meet king, king gave him favor. He stretched his hand towards her and she obtained favor. And when he said, let Haman come, I want to give you and Haman special treat. So Haman was happy. I am the man of the town. And he gave them food. And he promised them that by this time tomorrow, I will prepare food. And Haman was happy. Haman went home. That is verse 9. Verse 9 said, then went Haman forth that day joyful with a glad heart. But when Haman saw Mordecai, as they come out from the ghetto, in the king's gate, that he stood not up nor move for him. He was full of indignation, wrath, anger against Mordecai. Nevertheless, Haman refrained himself. And when he came home, he sent and called for his evil friends. And Zeresh, I put evil there, his wife. And Haman told them of the glory of his riches. He was boasting because he knows that tomorrow is a special day with the king. The glory of his riches and the multitude of his children and all things wherein the king has promoted him. He was rejoicing this day. And how he has advanced him above all the princes, above the princes and servants of the king. Haman said, moreover, yea, Esther the queen, did let no man come be with the king unto the banquet that she has prepared, but only me. And tomorrow I am invited unto her also with the king. Yet, all these things I just explained to you people, with the promotion, with the joy, with the that I'm the one preferred. Yet, all these things availeth me nothing. So as long as I see Mordecai the Jew sitting at the king's gate. The Zerach, his wife, and all his friends said unto him, let's build a gallow, be made of 50 cubits high. And tomorrow, speak down unto the king that Mordecai may be hanged there. Then go down in merrily with the king unto the banquet. And the thing pleased Haman, and he caused the gallows to be made. Calabash. He was so happy. Say, I'm about to be promoted again. You see, not only the king value me, I am the best among all the king's servants. Even the wife Esther value me. Imagine Esther calling me to come and eat with the king. So tomorrow is a special day. He got home, called his friends, called his princess, his wife, and said, let's celebrate. I've been promoted. I have good children. I have money. He was boasting about everything he had. After the boast, he said, but I am not satisfied. As far as I was coming out, I saw Mordecai. Immediately I see Mordecai, everything I'm to enjoy, I hate it. Until I see Mordecai died. And the friends and the wife just said, okay, we have a solution. Let's help you prepare gallow, a place where they can hang him. Make it very high. Tomorrow, after eating Esther food, I don't believe he knew that Esther. He didn't know that Esther was Mordecai. He doesn't know because it was not revealed yet. After Esther has finished giving you food, and you now eat with the king will now ask you, what is your request? Let Mordecai be hanged. He said, powerful. I don't know who is planning for your arrest, though. You will see what will happen later. He said, okay, they prepared it. And God was looking. Was God sleeping? God was watching how Naaman was planning for his own arrest. Naaman was happy. I believe that night, Naaman will have a dream. where he saw the Mordecai hang. He will dream it all. If it was to be written in this chronicle, maybe Gloria Chronicle. Haman will sleep that day and see where, as he sleep, he will see where he drag Mordecai, drag out. He will see how he stretches out towards the king, and the king say, go and hug Mordecai. If he wake up, he tell him, I say, I have a dream. Do you know that Mordecai was hung yesterday? He have dreamt it. Because the gallows was there. So the gallows must bring a revelation. Whether a dream or revelation, the gallows must speak. And Haman relax. But the conclusion where we are going to read today, Esther, next page, 6. Esther 6. On that night, Esther chapter 6 from verse 1, could not the king sleep. The king was to meet with Haman the next day with Mordecai. Haman and Esther. But Bible says, after the gallows has been made, God has seen it. On that night, could not the king sleep. And he commanded to bring the book of the record of the Chronicles. That was the record from the beginning. And they brought it and read before the king. And it was found written that Mordecai had told of Bigthana and Teresh, two of the king's chamberlains, the keeper of the door, who sought to lay hand on the king Ahasuerus. And the king said, what honor overnight to death? What honor has been done to Mordecai? The Mordecai that is to be king tomorrow. Now the king found a book overnight and he asked, what honor has been done to Mordecai for this? Then said the king's servant, the minister unto him, there is nothing done for him. And the king said, who is in the courts? Now Haman was called into the outward court of the king's house to speak unto the king to hang Mordecai on the gallows that he has prepared for him. I don't want to prophesy early. Kaliapusha. By the time Haman was coming to the king's house, God said, Haman is coming to ask to kill my son. But the king asked for the book of Chronicles that was never asked for a long time. The king brought book I was reading. As he was reading, Haman was singing from his house. Today is the day of devil. It can't be amen. Because he was a devil. But as he sang with that joy, today the whole provinces, they will hear of me that it was Haman that killed Mordecai. Not David killed Goliath. Haman killed Mordecai. He wanted to come and ask the king, give me the head of Mordecai. At that very time was when God said, king, the heart of the kings are in my hands. I turn it to where I pleases. Oh king, pick that book. And the king picked the book. As he read it, he saw Mordecai did a great work. And he said, what honor? A man that was about to be disgraced and killed. He said, what honor was done to this man? And there was another menu man there, Abimenuka, a servant. He said, nothing has been done. He said, okay, who is there? So that the person will help me honor him. Maybe he just wanted to say, give him something good or give him one thing. Listen to the story. So Emma, and the king's servant said unto him, behold, Emma standeth in the court. And the king said, let him come in. So Emma came in gorgeously. Gloria says so. And the king said unto him, what shall be done unto the man whom the king delighted to honor? Now Emma thought in his heart, to whom would the king delight to do honor more than myself? And Haman answered the king, for the man who the king delighted to honor, let me suggest, let the royal apparel be brought, which the king used to wear. King, bring your agbada, wait till they bring occasion. Because I may be Haman one wear around. Greedy wish. Let that loyal porridge, which the king uses to wear, which means it's not everyday clothes, use it to wear each time he's going to occasion. Since I am the one that thought I am the one, let them bring it. King was listening to him. And the horse that the king rideth upon, the king also, many horses are there. And the crown royal, which he set upon his head. Can you see? The crown of the king. And I could see the king listening to him. And let this apparel and horse be delivered to the hand. He don't let her say to me. He just wanted to first of all cover there. Let it be delivered to the hand of one of the king's most notable princes. Don't use another servant to decorate me. Bring your best and give them this things. That they may array the man, make them beautify him, beauty contest. So that they will beautify him, paint him, designer. That the best of the king people, they will array the man, array, beautify him. The man with that whom the king delighted to honor. And bring him on horseback through the city, may the whole world see a man. And proclaim before him who is the one the king must honor. I am the one the king must honor. He said, let them proclaim before him. Then shall he be done to the man whom the king delighted to honor. I think somebody at this point said, let my enemy cancel work for me. Maybe you never know where will they go. So he has suggested. Verse 10, then the king said to him, man, okay. You want to wear my agbada? You want to sit on my horse? You wear my crown? Then they carry you walk out for streets. They sing, follow you. Who is the one the king has on? Emma is the one the king has on. Who is the one the king? He goes, they say, hey, Zeresh, my wife, honey, where are you? Hey, where are my friends? Hey, Emma, I've arrived. Hey, I could believe he has a special song he will be singing. He don't already see himself on top of the horse. The dead king wore that cloth, he loved it. He don't see himself inside that cloth. I believe he also dreamt it. That was that because he planned what he will say. He has seen everything. After everything, verse 10, then the king said to him, be fast, make haste, and take the apparel, what you requested, the horse, as thou hast said, and do even so to Mordecai the Jew that seated out the king's gates. Let nothing fail of all that thou has spoken. Somebody said good thing back to sender. Now, when you say good thing, that good thing, leave me the sender coming to me. Okay? Now, who the king wants to honor? Who thought, assume, presume? You know, there are some people you just not send you. Before uncle, now me now. It's my duty. Who else? Come and eat with me today. Now me. He has made up his mind. The king, no, who is that person? Why did the king? Everything was divinely arranged. Queen Esther said, come and eat today. Because of the love they have for me. Our king said, oh, so this is the honor. What will be done? He said, same. The worst thing, let my enemy live long and see what I'll become in future. Sometimes it's very good. I told you, the Bible says, in the presence of your enemy, he will feed you. I told you, your enemy will take place. And I told us that it's very painful to you to eat fried rice with all the scent and perfume and curry. And the enemy, therefore, they watch you, chuman. And you are not giving him or her. After it, you say, will you take that plate there and clean it? I said, it makes person mad. It's madness. When you tell the enemy, just clean. Make sure you clean it or clean it. Hey! The king said, I love your prescription. Help me. You say I should use a very honorable man. You are really honorable, hey man? But a honorable man is about to dress against man. Carry the lotion. Bring these things. There is a gate man at the gate. A Jew. If it was another gate man, it would have been better. But the same gate man that have arranged the gallows, the same gate, it's not possible. I think Emma will believe that the king is hypnotized. What could have happened over there? That's when the Lord turned against our captivity. What happened? The same king, the same my friend, and Emma packed everything, decorated Mordecai. Mordecai, I believe Mordecai will just do it for me. My friend, put it on where? So you now call Getsma. The same man that I planned to, he don't arrange where he go kill me. That I know that anytime he see me, want to kill. He said if he see him at all, he doesn't lose appetite. He see Mordecai, the bitterness of death. Any bitterness that comes to the extent of death, he has at least today and the day we ever see this man. As far as Emma was concerned, finally, after today, no more Mordecai. Let me have peace. And the Lord said, let's bring Mordecai. When they brought Mordecai, what are they calling me for? As he came in, he knows he's God. They said, Emma! He said, Highness, bring that cloth. Mordecai, the king has chosen to honor you today. And the person that will beautify you is Haman. Hi. Put yourself in that shoe if you are not feeling for him. You are feeling for him. To dress your enemy that you want to kill, and the gallows is still there. What you look at the gallows and your wife and your friends? And they brought him and he dressed him. The king apparel. He wore it. Haman, Mordecai repaired himself. Emma tied that rope of that trouser very well. Emma tied it. Emma put on the shoe. I trust the children of God, though. Mordecai will show you that there is anointing he was carrying. Emma put on the shoe. Emma put on. Emma cannot look at Mordecai's face because he was a dead man. I could feel Emma would just. Emma was dead. That was a dead corpse already. There was no life in him. To dress your enemy. You will never dress your enemy in Jesus' name. But your enemy will make provision for your dressing. This one, we are reading scripture. And he dressed her. He don't finish. He said, go and bring the horse. He bring the horse. God is too much. From Getsma to palace. Somebody that was to be dead, that all the family, generation was to be wiped off. What could have happened from Getsma to palace? And the worst case, the enemy that wished him dead was the one that sang along with him. Mordecai is the one the king have honor. Emma thought he was the king. He was the one the king wanted to honor. I believe he could sing that one from halfway. I be saying na me wa honor. It's what did you say? Mordecai is the one the king of honor. I be saying na me the king. Let's say Mordecai is the one the king finally honor. Sing it loud. Mordecai was singing along. Emma was singing along. Mordecai. He become boy to a gate man. Calibre shatter. When God enter a matter. When God enter a matter, tell me if Mordecai ever dream that the next day his day will break. He never thought of it. Because the gallows were already there. But you know what I love? We conclude with that before we pray 1 minute. In chapter 7, verse 5 to 10. In chapter 7, verse 5 to 10. Then the king answered and said unto Esther the queen, who is he and where is he that doeth presume in his heart to do so? By this time Esther had told the king what Haman wants to do. And Esther said, the adversary and enemy is this wicked Haman. Then Haman was afraid before the king and the queen. And the king arise from the banquet of his wife with wrath into the palace garden. And Haman stood up to make request for his life to Esther the queen. For he saw that there was evil determined against him by the king. Then the king returned out of the palace garden to the place of the banquet of wine. And Haman was falling upon the bed whereon Esther was. Then said the king, will he force the queen also before me in the house? As the word went out of the king's mouth, they covered Haman's face. And Habona, one of the chamberlains, said before the king, behold also, the gallows, 50 cubits high, which Haman have made for Mordecai, who has spoken good for the king, standeth in the house of Haman. Then the king said, hang him there. So they hung Haman on the gallows that he prepared for Mordecai, and the king's wrath was pacified. Can we stand up and pray? Now when I stop there, it's because we just pray a prayer. The last verse of the book of Esther said Haman was not made next to the king. When Haman died, Mordecai now took the place. I think it's there. Thank you. For Mordecai, the Jew, next to the king Ahasuerus, and great among the Jews. When Haman died, the space was empty of Haman, because Haman was next to the king. Do you see, no matter how influential somebody is, if he touched God's anointing, if he touched God's children, he would die a death. So I don't know the gallow that will be prepared somewhere. Let the owner of the gallow be hung there. That is what you are going to pray. Whatever has been standing between you and your progress, let the gallows of Haman, the gallows of the strong man in your father's house, the gallows of sickness, the gallows of poverty, every gallows that has been prepared for me, in the name of Jesus, hang there. Every strong man in my father's house, every strong man in my mother's lineage, every power from the grave, from the pit of hell, wherever you are, that I've been fighting against my life, every agenda, every demonstration, everything you have gathered to fight against me, let it begin to fight against you. Let it begin to fight against you. Let it begin to fight against you. Ikayalalalalalalalosha barakatatatatas nikabasekelebredosh rikalebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebarebareb that every evil man, evil woman that say we don't have peace, that say we don't have rest, every evil man, evil woman that have assigned to destroy me, every of your agenda, backfire, 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 in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray. Every scripture have a spiritual backing. Every scripture have a spiritual backing. I don't know who have ganged up against you, but in the spiritual realm, but in the serpentine kingdom, anywhere they gang up against you, fire scatter there, fire scatter there, fire, open your mouth and decree, like Kababasha, every gathering against my life, fire, 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 ya, 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 like Kababasha, brothers, fire, 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 every gang up, every gang up, every gang up against my life, against my family, fire, 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 fire,
coming, can I just tell us the name of the Most High God?
Bless
the
O sanobano pere o sanobano gomerai o sanobano